Sir, I think Imran Khan wants to prove that he is a true Pathan son because he appealed to Modi to give peace a chance. How to look at the statement, sir?
So it's like murdering a person and then asking for compassion.
Mm.
So if India always gave chance for peace, it is a Pakistan which plundered and pillaged all hopes for peace. So the Pakistani Prime Minister is not actually making this statement targeting India.
Mm.
He's making this statement targeting the international community. Because after the Pulwama attack, the global community reacted. United Nations Security Council made a statement condemning the incident and naming Jaish-e Mohammed.
Yeah.
So Pakistan wanted to ensure that the United Nations doesn't speak out using its ally China.
Mm.
China has opposed it, resisted it, but subsequently China also fell in line because the argument of the United Nations was Jaish-e Mohammed has on its own accepted the responsibility. It's claimed the responsibility and Jaish-e Mohammed figures among the terrorist outfits outlawed by the United Nations. So therefore when UN Security Council had took this stand, China had to fall in line and a unanimous resolution condemning Pulwama has been approved, has been passed. So subsequent to that, Imran Khan also started acting on the terror outfits. The Jaish-e Mohammed office in Punjab province has been taken over by the Pakistani government.
Mm.
So there has been, there seems to be some semblance of action. Interestingly, instead of arresting the mastermind Masood Azhar, they have taken into custody Hafiz Saeed, the team people. So this shows lack of commitment, but trying to provide international community with their message that Pakistan is acting.
Trying to avoid the heat, sir.
Obviously, try to avoid the heat and present to the international community as if it is a law-abiding nation. So the objective of the Pakistan is not to curb terrorism. The objective is to fool the international community. So that is precisely the reason it started acting after the UN Security Council reacted and Imran Khan said we'll follow the United Nations decisions.
Mm.
But the fundamental point is that Pakistan remains a safe haven for terrorists. Pakistan remains a breeding ground for terrorists. So it's still, even while asking for a peace, Imran Khan says, show us the evidence about the Pulwama.
Mm.
What nonsense is speaking? The Jaish-e Mohammed has already acknowledged and accepted and declared that it is the mastermind or it organized the Pulwama attack.
Mm.
And Jaish-e Mohammed headquarters is in Pakistan. So what is he talking about? What evidence does he want? An organization, an outfit that already claimed responsibility has its headquarters in Pakistan. United Nations outlawed outfits and lead on terrorists are stationed in Pakistan. What else he wants? Osama bin Laden was staying in Pakistan. Can there be anything bigger acknowledgement of Pakistan's complicity with terrorism? Where was Osama bin Laden? Osama bin Laden was very near to Islamabad and staying almost near it, within the military establishment headquarters at Abbottabad and outskirts of Islamabad. So, Osama bin Laden, who was the son Al-Qaeda leader, took shelter in Pakistan. Imran Khan should be ashamed to speak like that.
Mm.
A country that provided residence to dreaded terrorists like Osama bin Laden speaks about peace. It is not a devil's quote in scriptures, it is. So, nobody is ready to accept this kind of a logic. Imran Khan is under pressure now. He is under international condemnation now and is forced to do that.
Mm.
So he may have friends like Saudi Arabia, he may have friends like China or America, but international community knows very well where exactly the address of terrorism. So India has to intensify its diplomacy. In fact, instead of warmongering, that will give Pakistan a chance to claim to be a peacemaker.
Mm.
I have been maintaining right from the beginning, when India talks about war, when India speaks the language of war, it is an advantage to Pakistan. Pakistan will go around the world and tom-tom that it is under attack from India.
Yeah.
India is an resorting to aggression. Pakistan is a peace-loving nation. So let us not give Pakistan a chance. Instead, we should unleash an aggressive diplomacy to isolate Pakistan. How should we do that? Mm. Today, there are several nations which are victims of terrorists. Iran is one example. Recently, there was a blast in Iran, and Iran has openly condemned Pakistan for that. Afghanistan has always maintaining that Pakistan is responsible behind the Taliban upsurge in their country. Mm. France is a victim of Islamic terrorism. Russia earlier had the problem of terrorism in Chechnya, fomented and encouraged by the Pakistani elements. China has the problem of Islamic terrorism in its Xinjiang province. So these are the nations which are facing the problem of terrorism. Okay. And of course, America is the major center for terrorist attacks. So therefore, India has to intensify aggressive diplomacy by joining hands with Iran, Russia, France, even America, and even convincing China. Mm. So that's the only way. The India's success at UN indicates that it's possible to corner Pakistan. So instead of that, if we talk the language of war, it's an advantage Pakistan. Mm. Well, if the war is thrust upon it, we'll certainly fight it.
Yeah.
War, as I always maintain, war should be a last resort. We should not invite war. We should not solicit war. But when the war comes, we should not hesitate to fight war. There's a difference between not hesitating to fight war and welcoming war. So this will only give an advantage for Pakistan. So we should show the Pakistan, we should expose the hypocrisy of Pakistan. So where is the question of peace? Where did India prevent peace?
Mm.
So when Pakistan Prime Minister says give peace a chance, who has not given peace chance?
Mm.
So India has always, did India encourage terrorist attacks anywhere in the world? Did India sponsor any terrorist group? Well, if any hawkish elements within India speak some language, well, that India is not part of that.
Mm.
As a nation, India never encouraged terrorism anywhere in the world.
True.
And never exhibited any extraterritorial interest.
Mm.
We are the victims of terror. We are craving for peace. That doesn't mean when we say that we will retaliate, when we say that we will teach a lesson to the Pulwama masterminds, that is not disrupting peace.
Mm.
So a self-respecting nation cannot continue to face this menace.
Yeah.
So we are fighting the menace of terrorism. Pakistan is exporting terror to us. So it's a mockery, it's a joke of the millennium.
Mm.
When Pakistan Prime Minister says, give peace a chance.